Hello everybody, my name is Jordan Brown and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be going through a little walkthrough slash tutorial on the recent video I shot about a watch, which you can view right now. I've been having dreams, jumping on a trampoline, flipping in the air, I never land, just float there. Okay, so yeah, we're going to be going over how I actually color graded the shots for this video, and I use the same color grade for pretty much all the shots. And I just copied it across because it looked good enough, so I could just use it across and it worked. I shot all the shots at the same setting, so the color grade just worked across them all. I shot these on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. I shot in B-RAW at 4K at a compression of 12:1. I also shot them all at ISO 100, and I'm not sure what f-stop I had, but I was using a 50mm lens. Whatever exposure looked correct, I adjusted the aperture. I wanted to shoot at ISO 100 just so I can get the least amount of noise. And so the setup for this video was, there was the watch obviously here, and we have a tube light along the top of the frame. I have another tube light, which is the actual light which is shining across the watch, which I'm actually hand-holding and just literally moving across. So you have the watch. I have a piece of black muslin fabric underneath, and then I have a glass pane, which I found somewhere, layered on top. If I were to do this again, the only thing I would change was I'd get an actual decent piece of glass, because you can see on this one it has lots of scratches. I tried to move as much dust as possible, but there's always going to be some. You can also see a bit of dust on the actual watch face, which is kind of annoying. And I also might have left some fingerprints on it, which you can possibly see on the glass. But if I were to do this again, for an actual client, then I would put a bit more effort and time into actually trying to fix a lot of these issues to make it look more professional. But I think it came out quite well for the time I had and what I did with it. Okay, so let's get into the actual color grade. I was initially going to actually do a tutorial and start from scratch and show you how I made these shots, but after starting the actual tutorial, I figured out I wasn't going to be able to get it to look the same. I don't know why. I could have wrote down all the different values I had, but that would have taken too long. So I'm just going to walk through what I actually did to color grade this shot. And by the way, I'm using DaVinci Resolve 15. It came free with the Pocket Camera 4K, so I might as well use that. But you can use anything to color grade. You watch this and see how I did it, and you can apply the skills that I use to your own grades. Okay, so to start off with the first node, we have the noise removal node, and I didn't actually use noise removal in this footage, but I have that node there just because that is where I would use it. If I were to use it, I would go here, temporal noise removal, whatever settings I needed to put, but because there was little to no noise in this footage, you won't be able to see it because of the YouTube compression, but there was little to no noise, and I was going to be using this video for Instagram just as a test. There was no need to use noise removal. Okay, so the second node, I have the buttery LUT on. So I just turn this off. If I just turn all the grades off actually first, just so you can see. So I have the buttery LUT, and this is what it is initially. It looks kind of cool, but obviously not what we want. I used a buttery LUT to convert it to, I believe it's the Rec 709 like workspace to be working in, or color space. And honestly, this actually looks so good. This light is so amazing. I want to note, you don't need this LUT to do this. You can use the built-in one which Resolve actually offers if you go Blackmagic Design and choose one of these. So I'm guessing film to send a LUT like that. Obviously a different look, but you'd obviously adjust all your settings to match that. But I decided to use this LUT because, one, I have it and it does look pretty good, and it's quite impressive actually. So the next node, we have the saturation node, and this, to do saturation, I pretty much do it the same way each time. Normally these bars are like this, obviously leveled out properly and all that stuff, but normally they're not at the top, so I just bring them up, drag, all the way up to the top. And normally, that is way too oversaturated. So this is what you get when you drag them all up. You get something that looks like this. is what it's default to, and that is way too saturated, so I've just brought it down to level of 30, and that looked pretty good to me. Okay, the next node is the white balance node. Obviously, right now, well, you can't see it just yet, but right now, this is what the image did look like. It was way too golden for my taste. I was kind of going for a more, like, really clean look for this, and I normally associate clean looks with the whites being perfectly white, and I would normally associate to be more cooler tones, like the professional, like high class look, and to do that I just used this color picker down here. So if I reset this quickly, I used the color picker down here to get white balance and just clicked on that, and it sets your white balance perfectly. Because obviously I knew this was white, this was a white bright light, so I knew that was white, so I can just set that to that and get the correct white balance that I wanted. Okay, so for the next node we have the watch exposure, so you can see a before and after there. I used a simple a window, or whatever they're called, power window, sorry. And it looks a bit off position there. I think I may have copied this across, but yeah, just a simple window, just so I could brighten up just the watch face, because obviously that is the most important part of this actual shot. It's just simply that. Onto the next node, which is the desaturation node. And for this, I believe, yeah, I just went into the hue versus saturation. I selected this color here and then decreased everything except that color. So I brought down everything else. Not to complete desaturation, but to pretty much where it's all desaturated. And I think this gives a really clean look. In black and white, it looks super professional, super sharp. But obviously we're keeping the actual colors of the actual watch, which is quite important to showcase the product. It also removes the color from the background, so it makes it look like a perfectly black backdrop, I guess. Okay, next node we have sharpness. And I'm not actually sure when to say this because of, again, the compression of YouTube. Well, that's before, that's after. I added a slight bit of sharpness just because I wanted to sharpen it up, obviously, with more professional videos and like product showcases. I want it to be tack sharp, and I may have missed the focus on this a bit, but that sharpness just fixed it up. And to do that, I just went into this blur sharp tab, went to blur and decreased it from, it's normally at 0.5. all the way down to 0.46, not too much. If you drag it too much, it's going to look horrendous and all the halos around it, but that is just enough for it to look still realistic. Okay, so we have the ninth node in this, and that is the exposure ramp, as I'm going to call it, which is basically, as you can see at the top, because there was a light up here, obviously the light source is coming from there, I wanted to darken that to make it not as obvious, not as like gradient as it is at the moment. I simply created the power window and feathered it to max, and then just darkened it by dragging that gain slider. Not too much, otherwise it's going to look weird because it's going to have the shadow on the light, but just enough that it actually makes a difference. And yeah, I think it looks quite good. Onto the last node, so you can see a before, after. This is just a simple darken. To do this, I decided to use the qualifier to select the brightest parts of the image, and then I just selected the brightest part, sorry, as you can see here, using the luminance, and then used that to actually just dim all the darkest parts by just inverting it. Over here you can see a bit of funkiness going on, which I can just fix by doing that, and yeah, we just get more focus on the actual subject of the video. So as you can see again, here's a before and after. There's quite a huge difference, I'd say. You can see we have some detail in the original, we have some details underneath, you can see details underneath the light. We've completely blown them out, which is fine by me. I think that's the look I was going for. Yeah, also one thing to mention as well, while I was color grading this, I was always checking the scopes to see that my black level was not getting completely crushed underneath the zero point. But yeah, that is how I color graded that shot, and then to crop it across, I just went color, save memory A, and then applied it to each one of these shots, making minor adjustments. And yeah, that's basically how I did it. I wanted to give this video quite a dark look and mysterious like vibe, sort of like an Apple or Microsoft ad, something similar to that. But yeah, that is how I color graded this video. I hope you enjoyed the process, and yeah, thanks for watching. I will be uploading a bunch more videos soon, and yeah, I'll see y'all next time. Peace. Splashing in the summer street, tripping, I fall in.